Recruitment played a critical role in the development of the Urban Teacher Academy, and it required us to do some very careful work with principals, with guidance counselors, teachers, to really look for students who have a true commitment and passion to want to become teachers with a particular focus in the urban environment.
We get started in just a couple of moments in the auditorium. For our parents who are here, you're welcome to join us for the beginning of our program. To be an opportunity for all of us to learn from each other, to share ideas, and to make a lot of very, very exciting friends.
The fact that you are saying you are interested in helping out in urban districts in this state, one of the most diverse states in the nation, where the needs in our cities are huge, with wonderful, wonderful people who need the opportunity and the support and the love and the caring and the commitment that you must have to do so. It is a calling, it is not a job. And I have full confidence that you represent that future, and that gives me great, great hope, great hope. So have a wonderful 2 weeks. I know you'll learn a lot.
Thank you.
It is much further if we are to meet the challenges of No Child Left Behind. This requires, on your part, future teachers, great levels of energy, knowing the needs of your student population, more effective and efficient collaborations, good programmatic decisions, and the ability to communicate high expectations.
Our program was unique in that we had a 2-week intensive program, and in the development of that program, it became apparent to me that we needed to focus on three areas. One, giving our high school students a chance to experience life on a college campus, the interaction with college professors, the tour of the campus, the opportunity to really gauge learning about the pedagogies of teaching. We also felt very strongly that to become urban teachers, they needed to become familiar with the community. And we got them out of the college environment into the community in places like the Trenton Soup Kitchen, Mercer County Special School District, the Boys and Girls Club of Trenton, to give them a firsthand experience of what urban life was like and also how those of us who are committed teachers play a role in meeting the needs of kids from those particular centers.
It's indeed a great pleasure to have all of you here.
Our Urban Teacher Academy students had the opportunity to meet and discuss issues pertinent to urban education with the interim superintendent of the Trenton Public Schools, Mr. Raymond Brush.
We need to have the brightest and best creative, and you are those individuals.
We were very pleased to be welcomed to the Monument School in Trenton by Principal Gail Cropper and Assistant Principal Bernadette Trapp.
No longer can we use those things as excuses. I believe in personal responsibility. I also believe in making children responsible for their own learning.
The kids who come from good families that are really trying. Maybe the parents are just caught up in something.
When we arrived at the Boys and Girls Club of Trenton, we had Dave Anderson, the director, give them an overview of the organization and then assign them to a variety of activities where they had a chance to participate, and encourage, and be involved, and get a sense and a feeling for the children who are certified. The children in Trenton, like children everywhere, often are involved in camp or community projects or activities that would give them a sense of purpose and a sense of well-being and a sense of socialization. There were opportunities for computers and technology and chance to really engage with adults in a positive way to fill much of the idle time that otherwise would exist and to provide support to parents who have to work, giving their children a place to go where they can feel safe. We had our students visit the Boys and Girls Club of Trenton to see the variety of activities that were being provided, games, swimming, and it was exciting to watch our urban Teacher Academy students jump right in.
Every summer, the College of New Jersey invites high school students who are thinking about becoming teachers to participate in the Urban Teacher Academy. One aspect of the application requires the students to write a letter to a teacher who inspired them. It's a reflection of how teachers are having a positive impact on young people who wish to pursue the field of education.
And it's always nice when a teacher hears a difference in the life of a child, and to have that student really interface with them to say, thanks for making a difference, and perhaps they may not have known the enormous difference that they made.
But it is really our job, but it's good to know that it's, it feels good to know that it's recognized, that it is appreciated, and very, very rewarding.
Similar things. They're called wire cutters or wire strippers. The electrons jumping through the gap from one piece of metal to the next that makes the whole LED glow.
One of the most exciting opportunities our Urban Teacher Academy students had was working with two outstanding local teachers, Mr. Chris Anderson and Mr. Chris Better. As a culminating activity to the Urban Teacher Academy, our students had the opportunity to work with Professor Linda Burrows on lesson planning and science education.
Part of design technology has several parts to it, one of which is the design challenge. And our design challenge was very simple. Make a costume from electric circuits that would light in the dark as the children were dancing. And in this way, we were incorporating electrical circuits into an everyday useful product. In this particular case, they were to design a costume that would light in the dark, that would be part of a dance performance. The dance performance would be a little routine that I would show them how to do. The background music would be from Lady Gaga's performance, and they would have a wonderful time seeing how MTV productions are put on.
Prototype something, anytime you make a product, you want your product to be a balance of form and function. It should be aesthetically pleasing, and at the same time, it should function well and work right.
This lesson was highly creative that provided our Urban Teacher Academy students with the chance to work with circuits and lighting for t-shirts that ultimately were used by our students to develop some creative dancing to really accentuate all of the principles that were learned during the STEM lesson. So much of what we did during the 2 weeks of our Urban Teacher Academy led up to the development and creation of our own school within the Urban Teacher Academy, where we brought in 28 fourth graders from the Ewing Summer Camp to really give our students an opportunity to try their hands at teaching. We developed a STEM lesson, a science, engineering, math, and technology lesson. This was a very exciting, energetic lesson that enabled our high school students to teach our elementary students the principles of circuitry. And using those principles, our students worked in cooperative groups, placing lights on t-shirts in a very creative way. In taking a look at the Urban Teacher Academy, we took students into our program, all of whom showed a passion and a dedication to want to pursue careers in teaching. And not only did they come here and learn about the college campus and the urban environment and many of the effective strategies that are part of teaching, but they also had an opportunity to be introspective, to learn about themselves and to see where they will fit into the teaching profession one day as they pursue their own individual career paths. It was very important that we added a component where students had an opportunity to try their hands at teaching, where they had the opportunity to be engaged with fourth graders, the opportunity to develop lessons under the direction of some of the teachers here at the college and myself, with the opportunity to leverage what they learned in a classroom situation to teach a math, a science, and a physical education lesson, to do some social activities, to give them the opportunity to see how they connect with young people. And the learning was just joyous.